Now we are going to see about the advanced recording options available with the WebHTML recording. Let's look at what are they. So these are the advanced recording options available. I will take you through each of them. The very first option available is the recording. Let's switch to the virtual user generator. You can launch this recording option either from your virtual user generator menu option. Okay, this is the one way that we can launch it, recording option, and the other way, so whenever you start recording button, so therefrom you can also switch the recording option. Okay, let's get into this recording option. So the very first one is the recording. See, this is the very important thing that we must remember. So basically, once your recording is done or while you're recording, the whatever the load runner APIs it generates or the script it generates can be generated in the two basic ways. One is the HTML based recording, another one is the URL based recording. So let's look at what your load runner by default gives some hint. What does it mean by? Okay, so it generates a HTML content based or HTML based script is nothing but it would be a context based script generation. Okay, it has the advanced option. Let's get into that. What is it contains? Okay, so again, this HTML based script has two different type of categories. So based on this different type of categories, we again get into different set of load generating options with respect to the static resources. So this below steps contains static resources or some extra resources apart from the main URL that we are hitting it. So let's look at this later. Let's look at it first. This very first option, a script describing user action. So if you use this first option, it will generate the APIs for the load runner using the web link and web submit form. For example, if you have opened a link, it will list out that link name instead of giving the background URL of it. Okay, and if you select this option, and for if you are submitting any form post parameters, and it will generate only the form post content of that particular script. Okay, let's get into more details of it. This about HTML based script and in advanced how the script will be generated if we select this option. Okay, let's get back. Okay, in our previous session we have already seen that if your script recording is done and you have made some changes, and if you don't want to make any, you don't want to keep whatever the changes that you have done, okay, and if you want to put the script back into the fresh recording, like this will regenerate, this regenerate script option will helpful in this case. So whatever the changes that you have done on your script, everything will be wiped out and it will create a fresh script. Okay, let's create this option. So this will also provide the again recording options the similar way. So I'm going to select, as I just said. So let's look at how this will be generating the script. Okay, just I'm regenerating the script. So it will take some time, a few minutes or a few seconds to complete based on your script length. See the very first URL, just look at. Okay, this is the web submit form which is generated. This API is generated by this recording option. So it is a context based. Okay, it clearly says web link and web submit form. So here the difference is, instead of giving a complete URL of whatever you have submitted, just it will provide the form post of it, nothing but the background form post name of it. Okay, it will not provide the complete URL of whatever you're submitting, just it will provide the context name of it. Likewise, for whatever the form post that you have done, everything will be shown with that respective form post context. And I also shown right here, for it will generate a web link. So in this web link, instead of giving the complete URL, it will only provide the front end text for it. Since we have clicked on Cura Healthcare button, right? So, or Cura Healthcare link, it will show up that link, only the link text. Okay, so these two APIs will be generated by this particular recording option or this particular level of script generation. Okay, let's look at, so we already just seen, right? So it will generate only context based. Let's say we have clicked on some particular link or we have selected some form, only the context of that form will be selected. Okay, and the second option is explicit URLs. It will generate the complete URL in background of it. Instead of giving some foreground form name, it will generate complete URL which is behind the foreground text. Let's see how it generates. So let me regenerate, go to option, URL advanced, say OK, click OK, click OK. So it will regenerate the script again. So whatever the changes we have done, once you regenerate, all the changes will be gone. See, now if you look at, so previously this was given as a just only this name here in the previous selection of script generation, it was only given like this. Okay, this only this particular context has come, but here it has generated a complete URL which is there in background, and it would be the same for all the script content. So, and here in previous session it was shown like in the web link, it was only shown like this. Instead of giving the URL, it was shown only the foreground link name. Okay, but here in this case it has generated their complete URL which is there in background. So this is the basic difference that we can get through as soon as we regenerate the script, or while we recording the script in this respective recording option. And so we just seen, right? So this will generate web link and web submit form, and this will generate web URL and web submit data. And what are this? So this is useful for generating the non-HTML content, like apart from your whatever the main URL. So there may be some background images, background URLs or the background requests which will be rendering as part of your page. Nothing, those are nothing but it may be the images, JavaScript, VB scripts, or ActiveX applets, anything. Okay, apart from your main request, so everything will be considered or extra elements. So those extra elements, whether you want to record them or do not record them, or record them into groups. Okay, let's get into it. Let's look at each of these options. So I'm selecting record with current script group. Just I'm regenerating the script. Let me regenerate. Record within the current script group. Click OK. See, if you look at here, the very first URL, previously these extra results were not there, because we have asked the script generator to consider these extra results or these non-HTML content. Okay, that's why we didn't see them in previous case. But in this case, we have told them like, please generate any static content as extra resources. Okay, so this is the option that we selected. So this is how it has generated as an extra resource. Okay, now let's look at the other option. HTML advanced, record separate step and concurrent groups. Let's look at how it generates. See here, it has generated an extra step called web concurrent start and web concurrent end. So under that, all the extra resources have been come as part of concurrent URLs. Means if your script generated like this, along with your main request, so this web concurrent start and web concurrent end, these methods says fire all these requests together in one single instance. So instead of loading them sequentially one after the other, it will instruct the load runner to fire all these requests, associate requests together as a single entity. Okay, this is the option generated by record in separate steps and use concurrent groups. So this is a very common option that majority of the industry will use in order to mimic like a real browser activity. Because whenever you started using browser, so though you are seeing one page in front, it may be containing a lot of background requests like CSS, JavaScript pages and images. So you are not asking the browser to load all of them, but browser knows it because it is internally, the main page contains it. So those will be loaded as a background concurrent part of the request. Okay, and the third option, do not record. Just if you select, those extra results will not come as part of your script. Just I'm regenerating the script, just look at it. So I'm just going to the home. See, now you didn't see any extra results like images, JavaScript, CSS, blah blah blah. Nothing was registered. It's a plain main request. So everything you are seeing, the plain main request, no extra results or no static resources, nothing was found here. Now let's go back and see what the other option we have. Okay, we have already covered all these two options. Now let's look at the URL based. Again, URL based have some advanced. So by default, this will generate everything as a URL like this. So what if you select this, it would also generate the web URL. And if you select URL based, this will also select web URL. But there is one more advanced option, like create a concurrent groups. This is also something similar to the HTML advanced, generate only URLs. But there is one more advanced option, use web custom requests. Okay, so this is a special case whenever your web URL or web submit data is not sufficient to generate any request. In that case, this, if we select web custom request only, then it will generate all the script content or all the requests as a web custom request parts. Okay, just click it and we will see how this will be generated. Just click on OK. So instead of generating web URL and web submit data, we will see everywhere web custom request. See how it is generated. And also we have selected one more option there, generate concurrent requests using the web concurrent starts and web concurrent end. Again, this is something similar to the previous recording option in HTML advanced. Okay, this is something similar to this. Just in this case, instead of generating web URL and web submit data, for every request, it may be get request or it may be a post request. In all the cases, it will generate only web custom request. Now let's go back. What is next available in option? The script part. Let's look at what this script option contains. In older version of LoadRunner, until 12.5, LoadRunner generating the script only in the C language. Now, since 12.5, it has the capability of generating JavaScript events in your LoadRunner code. And also in this script option, we have some advanced option, but which we would likely not to use very frequently. Generate fixed think time after end transaction. So we'll see in our later classes what is the meaning of think time, and generate recorded event logs. And also this we don't need to worry about it, and generate think time greater than threshold. So we will also cover about this later. Okay, so these most of the options which we really do not use as much whenever we try to record, either it may be very low level recording or basic recording, it may be advanced recording, we won't be used this much. We won't be using any of the options in this, except only for the think time, so that we will cover in our later classes. And now let's look at the other one, is the protocols. So here in protocols, since LoadRunner has a multiple set of protocols, basically it has divided into single protocols and multi-protocol model. Since we are only selected only WebHTTP HTML protocol, you are seeing that respective protocol. In some cases, if you select multi-protocol format, all the set of the multi-protocols will be available. Whatever the protocol that you selected, everything will be displayed. So while generating the code, if you want to select one particular type of the request for any protocol, you can select that particular one and you can leave rest of the protocol which you don't want to generate script for that. Okay, as of now, since we are only looking at the web HTML protocol, so we don't have much options. By default, we don't need to uncheck that, we just keep it checked and we don't need to change any option for this.